This is Good Morning San Diego.
6 o'clock on your Monday. Glad you could join us for a while this morning.
Yeah, we've got a great hour coming your way on this early Monday morning, including Phil Blair from Manpower is stopping by.
Yes, he is. And he's going to talk about telephone manners. We could all use some of those.
It is very important when you are in the job search. When was the last time you brushed up on your telephone manners? Been a while?
It's been a while.
Yeah, okay. Probably for most people, but it is very important to know your manners in case you have a telephone interview for a job interview.
Yeah,
Phil Blair from Manpower is going to stop by this morning with some helpful hints for you.
Coming up on Good Morning San Diego, maybe it's a lost art, telephone manners.
Yeah, boy, they do matter so much if you've got a job search. Phil Blair is stopping by with helpful hints. Well, your job search might start with a phone conversation. It's pretty common these days, so Phil Blair from Manpower is here to talk about telephone manners. And I guess, Phil, it's something that we don't think about too often.
Well, and that's why I want to talk. We've talked about interviewing skills and resume skills and follow-up and thank you notes. And I want people to know how important every aspect of the interview is. Mm-hmm. And it begins with that first conversation, which is typically a phone call, which is a test of your skills on the phone and communication on the phone.
Now, oftentimes that first phone call is not going to be the person directly responsible for hiring you, like the boss of the company. Might be HR, might be a receptionist, right?
It might be, and be as polite and friendly and accommodating with that person as you would with the president of the company.
Okay.
Because they all have influence, and they'll write a note about, person was very curt on the phone, or very friendly, seems like a really nice guy. You want that to happen. You want all those messages to build up for that job search.
How do you make sure that you come across as professional and put together when you don't know when they might call you? You're grocery shopping, you're picking up your kids from school. What do you do so that you can talk to them without sounding rude?
Well, first of all, the first call may set up a telephone interview.
Mm-hmm.
So before they fly you across the country or before they even have you come in, there are three or four questions they'll ask, and they're testing your ability to communicate on the phone. And it's important to know that if you're driving your car and picking up the kids and they're screaming, you're not going to be at your best.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very appropriate, because probably he or she is a mother or father, to say, can I call you back at 3 o'clock? I'm in the car driving right now and I don't feel comfortable having this talking to
mm-hmm.
you. And they will respect that. What I don't want you to do is, oh my gosh, they finally called me, I have to talk to them or what they're doing, and have a bad impression going on. So it's okay to do that. But take control of the situation. Mm-hmm. Say, I will call you, what number should I call you at 3 o'clock today? Because that's important. The other thing is, have your notes in front of you about the job, because
uh-huh.
they're going to ask you questions and you want to be knowledgeable about it. It's not just let's chat and be all buddy-buddy. It is part of your interview.
I'm surprised to hear you say you recommend using a cell phone if possible.
Well, be accessible.
Mm-hmm.
What you don't want to do is play phone tag.
Okay.
They call you, you call them, they call you, you call them.
Mm-hmm.
Because as soon as they connect with three candidates, they'll go, oh, we've got that taken care of, thank
mm-hmm.
you. And what that meant was I got a hold of the other three quickly. So don't have it be a cute phone message if they do get your cell phone.
Oh, okay.
Don't have the kids answer your home phone if you don't have a cell phone, which is kind of rare. I suggest people put their cell phone number so they're very accessible. And I don't care how you normally answer your cell phone, when you're in a job search, you answer it very professionally, because you never know who's going to be calling.
Okay, so finally, what's the one last thing we should say when we're hanging up the phone to ensure that they're going to talk to us again or call us in for an interview?
Ask, what time should I follow up? Would Tuesday at 2 o'clock be appropriate? Now they may say, well, make it 1 o'clock, but then you're boxing them in that you're going to take control. If you say, if they say we'll call you back, we say, would you like me to call you back?
Okay.
Try to take control of the situation without being pushy.
I love it. All right. Well, thank you so much.
You're
should have done this interview over the phone.
We could have.
Just for good practice.
We could have.
Thank you, Phil.
You're welcome.